No. Daycare! Hey, buddy! Crazy dog.
I'm a little crazy.
Happy dog.
Hi, buddy.
Oh, happy dog.
We're
happy
just going to scan decaf for a chip, to make a microchip, to make sure that we don't have one on accident, in case we came from somewhere other than you guys' kennel. We don't have a microchip. So now we're going to draw some blood for a chemistry panel and a red blood cell, white blood cell panel. It's called a complete blood count. We use the jugular vein for that and Vacutainer needles. So instead of having a syringe pulling blood, blood just flows right into the tube.
What a good boy.
He'd be a very good boy. He'd be a good, brave soldier.
Oh, good boy.
So decaf is really good for that. And then we're going to go, decaf is going to go up on the table and get ECGs. And then there's a microchip actually in the hub of this needle. In the hub of the needle, there's a microchip in there. And that goes underneath their skin. And then that way we can track them as far as identification purposes. And Sabrina will tell you about decaf going up onto the table to get his ECG, which is electrocardiogram. We use 6 leads on these guys. An electrocardiogram is just basically a machine that hooks up and has alcohol placed as a conductor. So the leads or the clips that get hooked on the dog are going to pick up the electrical activity of the heart, and that transmits it onto the machine and gives us a recording, and that is telling us how the electrical activity is moving through the heart, which tells us a lot about the function of the heart, the muscles, oxygenation.
Hi, decaf. Decaf says no big deal, huh, buddy?
I'd really like to watch these procedures.
Yeah, once we get them hooked up, we can watch the trace on the screen there, and we just like to make sure that it looks as good as it can, so the cardiologist, when he reads it, can see anything that may pop up. If we see any abnormalities, we'll run a longer strip on it, so the cardiologist has a little bit more to look at. So once we get him, decaf says, I don't want to hold still. They have to hold still for about 10 to 15 seconds, and then the machine will start. I'm not sure if you can see that. We'll start going through, and I'm switching the leads here, checking them all to make sure they're running well. And this is going to be a little wonky because he's moving. So we're going to run it over again, just so it comes out. Hold on, decaf. Right, I know. Hold on to my hand. You got me, but I got you, bud. I gotcha. He says, no, I'm not. I don't know where the word. You're okay, buddy. I know.
Relax. When you relax.
You're all right, baby.
I know.
We got this, buddy. We got this. 10 seconds of holding still. May or may not have.
Good
there you go.
Good boy.
We got mom on the front and dad on the back. Good job. Okay. 10 seconds, buddy. Don't run.
So this isn't hurting him, he's just
It's not hurting him, he's just having to hold still. We do use little alligator clips, but we grind them down, so they don't, they're just holding on to the skin. He just doesn't want to hold still.
Yeah, he's just...
he's just being wiggly because he's on his side on a table, and he's a sled dog, and he wants to be out gallivanting in the woods with his mom. Good job, buddy. I know. I think the hardest part of this is them just holding still for 10 seconds. Because that's a long time in sled dog terms. Okay, we've got him holding still. Let's try it, buddy. I mean, that's really like 80 seconds in dog seconds, so, you know.
And in decaf seconds, that's like 2.5 hours.
Yeah. And that's as perfect as decaf's gonna get because he's so wiggly, but it's very straight, buddy.
Good job.
It's very straight.
Now that's just not right.
Good job. I know. And now you want to roll. Oh, really? You told I know. That's the hardest. It was the hardest of all. Oh, I know. Poor man. Did you survive? Just barely? I know. Tell us all about it. And now we'll let him sit up. And then we'll actually implant the microchip, which for Iditarod goes behind the left ear. So like Tabitha showed you, the microchip is in this needle. And Allie will be my wonderful assistant here. And we will just put it there. And that's it.
Mine's right there.
Got one too?
Yeah. And then we always like to verify that it's there. And it's there. And then good dog. Number. Good dog, buddy, huh? Good dog. And that's it. Then he's free to go.
Official. Cool.
He's an official Iditarod dog.
Woohoo! Good boy.
She says, Mom, did you hear that?
So QT's going to have her EKG now. She's already had her blood drawn while we were doing decaf.
No, it's just they don't know what it is. It's hard to explain to them. Hey, you just need to hold still and no big deal. But most of the time they're like this where they're like, oh, okay, you want me to just lay here and be good? I'll lay here and be good.
So the placement of the leads is pretty, is standard. It's the same for every dog.
One on each limb, and then one over the apex of the heart, and then one on the back of the neck, and that gives us, that's our six lead reading, so it gives us a reading from kind of a couple different directions, I guess is how we call it. And QT says, I'm going to be so perfect. A good girl, and it's all done.
Well done.
Yep.
Just like that.
That was easy. And then we just wait for a second until the machine prints. Yep. And then once it prints and we make sure that everything looks good, then we can take her little leads off. So she needs to go talk to decaf and be like, dude, it's cool. It's really not that bad. And then we'll let her sit up and we'll do her microchip. And, you know, the girls are always tougher than the boys anyway.
Scoop.
Alright.
Nice.
And just like that, she's an Iditarod dog.
Just like that, and you she's an Iditarod. Yay, good girl. This is perfect. She says, I'm pretty perfect.